The meeting was attended by persons who believe that the formation of the National Center for Legal Aid and Human Rights will help ensure that citizens get equal and just treatment. Over the years, there have been several incidents locally that have called St. Lucia's human rights record into question. In fact, one U.S. State Department report recently listed police abuses as this country's most serious human rights problem. But human rights advocates say the problems also include court delays and the seeming impunity with which criminals operate. And they believe a functioning center for legal aid and human rights will help address those problems.
The organization has existed for many years, but the meeting here this afternoon is an attempt to actually build up the membership, leading on to a formal launching on the 10th of December, 3 weeks from now, International Human Rights Day, and I'm very glad for the turnout this afternoon, because as I say, one of the main factors limiting the capacity to work is the absence of a membership and a proper structure. So from this meeting this afternoon, we're hoping to have an interim committee set up to see about launching of the organization and to have election of executive members and so forth.
Ms. Francis says the National Center for Legal Aid and Human Rights will undertake a number of projects and programs.
The question of prison monitoring, the question of providing assistance or legal aid to vulnerable persons, the question of police cells and whatnot. In other words, actually ensuring places where the state actually has persons in custody, that they receive humane treatment. This is just some of the work. You hear about the victims of crime complaining, if you can have a victim support committee as part of the overall organization. So we really want to be practical in our programming and to reach communities where they really need assistance.
The human rights advocate wants persons to speak out and continue fighting for their rights. The National Center for Legal Aid and Human Rights is expected to have a soft launch next month. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.